What is this thing called love? This funny thing.
The story of William Masters and Virginia Johnson, as perhaps none other, deals directly with the external mysteries of sex and love. Their public life provides an unparalleled window into America's sexual revolution and its historic cultural changes still with us today, while their private relationship mirrors many of the most basic desires, tensions, and contradictions between men and women. In a sense, this book took me 15 years to do. I first interviewed William Masters in 1994 as a health and science writer for the newspaper Newsday here in New York. And ever since, I was thinking about what type of story could be told about a man and a woman studying love and sex, and what type of extraordinary relationship they may have had.
Committed. May I ask each of you how many times each of you has been married?
I've been married. This is my second marriage.
This is my third.
Well, then let me ask you what you mean by commitment and what makes one commit. I mean, one could look at you and say, aha, you know, you're supposed to be the great authority. You've been married three times.
But it wasn't until 2005, when I gained the complete cooperation of Virginia Johnson, that this book really took off. I was able to convince not only Virginia, but many of the doctors and patients themselves to speak for the first time on the record. And they provided the definitive story of this extraordinary period in America's sexual history. For years, the work of Masters and Johnson remained shrouded in strict confidentiality as a result of their own desire to avoid public scrutiny. Only now, with a willingness of many to be interviewed and access to the letters, internal documents, and Masters' own unpublished memoir, can we fully consider their remarkable life and times. For all of the clinical knowledge they gained from America's biggest sex experiment, involving hundreds of men and women and more than 10,000 orgasms, their story is still very much about the elusiveness and indefinable aspects of human intimacy. As many today still ask themselves, what is this thing called love?